really want to push Amazing off the main three junglers. So much so that they're willing to sacrifice Lulu, something that Kwass has had so much success.
Especially the late game as well. You want to stay away from a Kog'Maw or a Trist if you have it. So it's either been Jinx or Corki that we're seeing. Now Jarvan does get locked in, Jap, so they're going to be able to lock him up, give him utility of Wild Growth. What will they be locking up, though? You're going to Cataclysm right onto a Maokai who's mitigating damage. A good disengage if they're actually able to take the Curse wanted to take. So it's going to be shield protection, and why not? You already have utility coming from the top lane. Bjergsen can give, or rather, Amazing on Jarvan can give himself utility on Jarvan with the shield and the standard. Pretty good composition, feeding each other stats during the fight.
It will be a very interesting game with these picks coming through. If the Ori is what he indeed does lock in. You can tell there's a little bit of indecision. Ori's just setting up, making sure his runes and masteries are settled. He wants as much time as possible before the pick eventually locks in. Which means that probably wasn't the plan from the get-go, if they needed to delay something like that.
Right.
I'm reading into things, but that's what I imagine would be true.
That's your job.
Boy. That's true, actually. To speculate.
It's good, though. Yeah. TSM, they do, as we were talking about, they get a bit of what they can pick with. It's not a Morgana, but they get Thresh. Mm-hmm. It's more of an all-in, though. Amazing is usually on a champion like Elise, like Lee Sin. Exactly. You can be in and out. This is, once they're in the fight, TSM's going to have to come in.
When you're in, you're in. You got to be very clean with your decision-making. Which hasn't been TSM's strongest suit. Mm-hmm. This split. Wow. Because the whole TSM team composition looks really solid. On paper, but then you consider the success that they've actually held on Jarvan, and it's been very low.
Yeah, absolutely. Before the battle begins, let's do a quick check-in with the folks over at LOLESports.com. That's you. Right now, it is 77% of the vote thinking, TSM's going to be taking this game. Not much for Curse.
Yeah, and we got something a little different for the Twitter vote today. If you think Curse is going to win because of their logo, send hashtag elephant on fire for Curse to win. Or if you think TSM will win, just a standard hashtag TSM win to the at LOLESports Twitter. We'll keep that vote going throughout the game.
See what Curse can do coming out of the gates on this one. They are going to have a pretty tough game. Like we said, TSM has been able to pretty much knock them down every time they've approached this, and it's going to be the last time Curse has to get their hands on TSM.
And there are so many trends going in different directions here, and something's got to give. So basically, we consider TSM's consistency against bottom-tier teams. Against the bottom three, they're 11-0. But at the same time...
Sounds good.
Amazing when he's not on one of his main three junglers, only has one win out of 8 or 9 games, right? So that's kind of going against themselves. And then you also, this is a one I was just seeing before the game, 4 out of the 5 losses that Curse has had in the past long while were to EG and Complexity. They're actually 0-2 against both of those teams. If you look at their last 8 games versus top 5 teams, Curse is 7-1. So they've been destroying top tier teams.
Sometimes the surge comes in a little too late for these guys, but it shows that they have it, that they can turn it on. Just when can they find it earlier? Bjergsen goes back. He forgets a little something. He goes for a scrying to start off in the mid lane. Looks like it's going to be also a Doran shield for Lustboy here in the bottom lane with Wild Turtle. Ooh.
It is on the line. I mean, Cloud9 were to somehow lose to CLG at the end of the day.
That would be bizarro.
Hey, that would mean that the TSM victory here would force a tiebreaker. TSM still not out of the race for that second place.
Kwass striking sticky fear into his opponents with the saplings.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
Slow movement. Wild Turtle's playing the same game Cop is, but just down the river. They live on the same street. It's all right. Whoa, Amazing. Being bold. Very bold. Standing in the face of crowd control and an unknown Eve. He could have been blowing a flash there, but they decide not to go aggressive, and they're just playing some wards.
Yeah, although TSM walks right over a ward on the way back to get a deep ward here. It's really just about trying to scout out Eve in the jungle. More so than any other jungler, she necessitates early game scouting. But no one dies in the early game scouting, so that's pretty actually good for TSM.
Very strong lanes coming out of them, at least with that early Phosphorus Bomb damage. And what Lustboy, if he can hit the hooks, bottom lane has a great chance at shutting down Cop early. Cop's not on his Corki, who's going to have that little push like I just said, of the Phosphorus. We saw him take down Jinx, and we've seen him actually Jinx double lift, I should say, and a few other AD carries 1v1. See if his confidence is still built up on that early game Kog'Maw. Kwass to the top lane after a quick bump on blue buff for Dominate, and we're going to get the lanes underway.
Cost himself a fair bit of mana in all those early game pulls, but he should be all right. The elephant is on fire. 68% win for Curse. That's the way it is. Clearly.
I would not want to be in the way of an elephant on fire. It probably
well, that's
not
where
safe.
TSM sees themselves right now. It's actually so curious here that with the way the matchups work, if TSM beats Curse, they guarantee that Curse falls to or sits in the sixth space, and TSM is most likely to finish third in the playoffs. So this would be a quarterfinal playoff matchup in the NALCS playoffs if TSM beats them,
right,
which is what they want to do. You go 4-0 against a team,
again.
You would love to face them in the playoffs.
Yeah. A very, very big lead in that aspect. TSM could create that opportunity for themselves today. I'm sure that's on their minds as they play throughout this one. Still watching to see how this play of the orb comes in. I know Dominate's been aggressive. Maybe it's to find where he is after he leaves Amazing trying to do a counter gank. Maybe they'll use that orb in just a few. Nope, Dominate's going to the top side. So it's going to be Dyrus. Zero mana right now. He's going to get some attention.
He should have enough for a...
Yeah, he got...
Oh, he just used it all.
Man.
Is that enough to move speed him away? This could be trouble.
Dyrus is forced to flash here. He's trying to get to the tri-brush wall. He's going to not flash. Holds on to the app. Because that's
Yet
where it is.
Another first blood for Curse. They are just on a rampage here. And that's the start they needed here against TSM, putting Dyrus already in a bit of a hole. Although he didn't burn his summoner spells, and he's
right.
Teleporting straight back to base.
Teleporting back and the pink ward. I mean, I guess there's not much he can do in the knowledge of Eve coming up. You're only going to have a vision at this point. So he makes that, or he remembers that and makes sure it won't happen again, I should say. Good hits, special, playing a lot of brush control. The caustic spittle as well from Kog'Maw to add a bit of damage. Good pressure in the bot lane.
And also keep in mind, the really good leash that Kwass gave to I Will Dominate was paid back for him right here. He's going to have to flash away from this one, but it still might not be a... He might not even bother.
Oh my gosh, very... You said paid back, Jack. There's some interest on that.
You betcha. Well, here's Jarvan's turn.
What a great flag in. Almost gets it off. Can they get it again? No! I said a flag in. It was a Lantern in. Use the flag. Almost gets the kill. Cop gets out alive. Not forced to blow up on anybody.
And they actually burned all four enemy summoners in the bottom lane there. So when Cop gets back to base, he's going to have a summoner spell advantage. But that was still a lot of CS and experienced missed. Just not the same as getting two kills on the jungler, though.
Well, that's what it looks like when you're trying to make up for having two kills on a jungler. TSM Amazing knew he needed to make an impact. Jarvan can do that. They blew a little bit too much, so we won't be returning down to the bottom lane for another attempt soon.
It just kind of goes to show you the power of Black Shield in that bottom lane as well.
Yeah, yeah.
X-Special put it on there, and they had to delay so long before trying to land the Jarvan knockup, so much so that they couldn't get it. And he ends up getting away with both summoner spells burnt.
He's farming in the mid lane. Actually pretty low.
He's level 5 minutes into the game right now. He could very well hit level 6 at about 6 minutes and then gank really powerfully early on, before people expect it.
And they're ready with the pink wards as well. He hasn't grabbed the sweeper just yet, but they're going to be able to start getting those high priority deep wards in, and he can be a menace even more. Mid lane for Amazing.
Plus, as far as being a menace, this is the game where Dominate can take blue buff on Eve, which means he can power farm with his edge and just try and turn into a really, really powerful Eve. It's actually something that is more common in solo queue, but because of the situation here, Dominate gets to do it with everything on the line.
This should
be level 6 right here.
The jungler always gets blue in solo queue.
Yeah, he just wants it. He just takes it. Whatever.
6 minutes on the clock, and that's a level 6 exactly for Dominate. Very nice clip in the game for him with these two kills to the top. And Kwass with those two assists, it's going to be great for Maokai. We've seen multiple times where Maokai falls behind and then can still be a great force. Putting him ahead in the early game is definitely going to make that tree something to be reckoned with.
Just the two assists, it's not a huge amount of gold, but considering all the time that Dyrus missed in the lane anyway, Maokai doesn't have the strongest early laning phase.
Mm-hmm.
It's really a huge boon to have Kwass get that
man,
early game
you gank
advantage.
For him.
Yeah, great gank support. They would love to actually turret dive Dyrus before he's level 6 here, but Amazing is messing up their plans.
messing up. Hopefully he can get himself to 6-2. He's also not getting much out of being forced to kind of wander around and make sure Dominate's not being too aggressive. Some of the forward wards now of Dominate have been placed. He still has his pink, but here's the teamwork coming in. That was from earlier.
Yeah, a bit of a wasted pink there.
Yeah.
Very easy for Amazing to clear out, especially because he made his presence so known. That pink is better if they don't see you placing it, because then they don't think to check for it.
Extending their stay a little too long. This will be a nice pickup here for Dominate. So he's going to have about a 13-minute return over to this blue buff. We'll see what he can get going on that. Dragon should be in the eyes of these teams quite soon. We already see TSM. They have the Death Brush pink ward down. Free farmer bottom lane here for Cop is not being pressured. Turtle and Lustboy actually really haven't tried to do anything in this lane. I guess we haven't really seen them do much. Lustboy has been very passive support since he started.
He hits
a lot, but they don't go on.
Considering
much.
The huge investment they made for that gank attempt,
yeah.
Cop is getting out of that mostly unharmed. The CS is staying close, and the itemization is near identical, save for a mana potion. Oh, Kloss just going to put some harass down because he can. No gank support.
Dyrus is like, thank God there's no Eve this time. He's just thinking to himself. Nightmares. So trade over. Now this makes Void Boy have to play a little different. He doesn't get the blue buff, so he does have to consider he's going to be facing more damage from Bjergsen as those spells come off and rip out a lot quicker.
Interesting move here. TSM just trying to go for it. They get spotted out. The collapse is absolutely possible by Curse. And Amazing took half his health, plus he gets knocked up!
Gets him before they hit the ground. Double teleport coming in. Oh my!
This
Who's
is not gonna, going
gonna
well.
Happen big. Amazing is helping, throws down the Cataclysm, locks down Kwas, but Dyrus is the last one fending for himself. He's trying to get to the wall. He can't flash that one either. He holds on to the summoners. 5-0, just 9 minutes in.
Curse absolutely decimates TSM right there for trying to sneak a dragon with no advantages. They hardly even had a vision advantage right there. Sloppy play by TSM, Amazing got low. It was a shortened lantern as well, which meant both of them got hit by Void Boy's tornado and they got destroyed.
This is great.
I mean, look at this, that lantern hardly moves them. It means Lustboy gets knocked up because he stayed for the lantern for some reason, and then Amazing still tries to go in. Bjergsen sombreroed his ultimate as well, and then was out of mana because he's just
that.
Done all that. Oh my god. Dyrus gets bound by the end, so he can't make the wall to flash over, and it's now 5-0 plus a dragon. 4,000 gold lead before 10 minutes.
What a game for Curse to have the weaker lanes and start coming out on top. Very, very big time. Kog'Maw now 1-0-0, 4 assists over to Kwas, and he's had quite a time for himself. Almost on that Rod of Ages before 10 minutes to start stacking up. Surge of power for Dominate on that Lizard, and Curse is using it perfectly, but we can't get too ahead of ourselves here. This is exactly what Curse loves to have. But then they get themselves into a bad situation.
If they get overconfident.
See if they can ward and keep it clean here. If they get overconfident.
They
right.
do have a very all-in composition, so overconfidence can be a good thing.
That's
when you're
true.
Like this, because you need to at least have the baseline of confidence to be able to make plays, which they definitely should be having right now with how many plays they have just made.
Strong game again from Dominate on Eve. Consistency there, and teams definitely have to make note of it. Ban could be considered for that champion. 3-0-1 already into the game, helping snowball lanes across the board. It hasn't even gone bottom. Knowing that Kop and Expecial kind of have it
man.
On lockdown, they now focus the middle. That's the flash from Bjergsen. His ult is up from the last fight. He uses it. Wow. Little bit of miscommunication. They can still come up with a kill, but I think Void Boy is going to be able to finish off something as well.
Yes, they do.
Great rotation from TSM's bot lane.
That was what gave them the confidence to go back in there. And that's really what ended up baiting Void Boy into going all in as well. I was thinking that, of course, they're going to win the 2v2. Think of how far ahead they are.
Yeah.
Turtle and Lustboy showing up at the 11th hour really pulled that one back. Double buffs onto Bjergsen and a lot of mid lane turret damage.
Little tunneled in on that one. Curse didn't have the wards behind Dragon. You can see that's owned completely by Team Solo Mid. Three wards right up that highway. Give them a kill and a way back into this game. They're not going to be able to gain too much pressure off of that, but at least it gets some gold onto Bjergsen now. Wild Turtle's able to get an assist and hopefully get his Phage finished. He's a few recipe items behind Cop right now.
And even with those two kills they picked off from the two most farmed members of Curse, they're still down over 3,000 gold.
Yeah.
The mid lane turret pressure was good, but they need to do that again so they can actually take the turret. And and then they would need Amazing to make a bunch of plays from there. But he's still pretty far behind on J4. So that is a good play, but it's the first of many that are required if TSM wants to come back in this game after a disastrous early game.
Yeah. I like to think junglers like to do things a minute before everything spawns. We know his blue buff's coming up at 13, so they want to get vision of everything TSM's doing on their side. Dominate's going to hover around this top and know his blue will be there. So we should see where Dragon's going to be coming from soon. Amazing. Waiting for his red as well. So both junglers doing their own thing. Lanes are safe for now. Little do they know.
The pick ward has been placed yet again. I wonder if he's going to check that spot. Because this is...
That's true.
This is now Dominate knowing exactly where Amazing is. Does he have the... No. It's kind of a discipline you need as a jungler to check that brush almost every time you're there, because it's a 3 or 4 second loss in efficiency, but the potential of clearing out those pink wards is probably worth it.
99-104 in this lane.
Pretty Dominate
standard.
Accidentally checks that one while trying to ward over the wall.
Wow. They really want that pressure.
You gotta be careful not to get caught out.
TSM doing a great job at being able to control their pink wards here. Curse was not ready to move on that, but their bottom lane is pushed up. So they're hoping they might be able to draw Amazing's pressure down to that. Get it off of mid lane here. Dominate back to that area. He's gonna clear it out right quick, and no. Just on the other side of the wall is Amazing, so they're safe. Minute 30 on Dragon. Blue buffs are gonna be transferred over to their respective champions. That means Bjergsen actually has double buffs at this point right now.
And the double buffs are one of the big reasons Voidboy's had to respect him so much. It definitely bought TSM a lot of time to stall out when they were able to get those two kills in the river. Especially them going on to Bjergsen is probably the best possible thing. He needs to be the carry for them this game. For them to come out on top.
That's what I'm thinking that Dominate's focus is going to be as well. I haven't seen too much from them. Boy has to synergize his own ultimate, so they aren't seeing that from the Eve Agony's Embrace, but getting those kills, shutting down the two from Bjergsen would be quite big. He's in the position to carry this game for TSM right now. Good job by Kwas in the top lane. Not to go crazy, but to hold the lead he was given from Dominate here and just play it consistent.
Curse has a lot of options this game. I mean, no matter what happens, it's kind of an unstoppable force for Kwas going into teamfights to then proc the Yasuo ultimate just with his Arcane Smash
right.
With a mini knockback. That's going to be so, so lethal when it gets to that. Xspecial wants to wait.
Nicely done. Good harass.
They are going to be able to get a fair bit of turret damage now that they've delayed that back. Xspecial wants to delay it farther.
He's going again.
Yeah, they're basically wanting him... Just that binding alone secures this dragon for Curse. They had the timer. They delayed the back of Wild Turtle. Therefore, they know there's no opposition for this dragon. Also, Amazing is back at absolutely the wrong time if they were hoping to contest.
Curse switching things up. They have both dragons in their favor when they would usually be the team to have the lead and be okay with letting that go. But on blue side, they were easily able to wrap around the dragon den. Pick that up for themselves. A 5,000 gold lead here over Team Solo Mid. TSM came off a pretty big win yesterday on Dignitas. We'll see if they can keep that run going here. Curse now looking for a third win in a row. Everybody's kind of making a surge. End of Super Week. Found nothing. Oh, we did.
Yeah.
I'm alive.
Congratulations, Boy.
It's just on the outside.
You found a ward. What do you get? Vision of him. Yeah, he's farming up pretty well. Equal farm for Bjergsen, though, so no huge lead being extended in that mid lane.
Bjergsen goes through alacrity boots quite quick as well. A little bit of movement speed for himself.
He's not going to let him have this. Oh, no! he got it anyway. He missed his smite. Oh, no, Turtle is in trouble.
Valkyrie! Hey. Ah, the lantern.
Burn heal for the Morgue ultimate. But again, Turtle has to go right back to base.
Ultimate. Great movement. One more QW. Oh, that W just on cooldown. He wasn't able to activate the dissonance. Very well played by Bjergsen, understanding the cooldown control.
Oh, Lustboy sees the Void Boy. You gotta go further back.
Lustboy plays. The Ignite burns. Oh, it burns so good. Void Boy goes down.
Flash auto ignite is enough, and that's the mid lane pressure. We said TSM was gonna have to do this again, but have they went and stayed too far? Have they gone?
Oh, there's the teleport coming in from Dyrus, though. Wild Growth is gonna save Lustboy on this one, or somebody. Dyrus actually doesn't put down the ultimate.
Off,
Amazing goes down, he's still holding. Dyrus won't even be able to use his ultimate in the fight.
They definitely...
Very peculiar.
Stayed for too long.
Ah, the dodges.
Two kills get spent back. And Cobb?
Cobb doesn't have that much mana. I'd be very afraid to pursue this one. No, maybe not. Dominate.
Whoa.
Very nice pan on the camera.
Oh, Quas going the long way around as well. These TSM guys are dead.
Nobody's getting out alive. They're going to say, wait, Quas wants a bit. Just kind of string him along so he can get there. But there go both going down 5-1 and 4 coming out of this Eve for Dominate.
The one slightly unfortunate thing for Curse right there was Dominate did pick up more kills. Evelynn doesn't scale the most generously, especially when compared to Kog'Maw. Take another look
again
at this one, though. It was just a collapse down. Dominate comes in and is so strong. And then Amazing actually got bound in the turret while trying to kill like Special. Some nice shots by Cobb over the wall. And at this point, there's just no stopping the chase of Quas and Dominate. They find a fight, they stay with the fight. Like Special delays for long enough. Everyone else knows what the game is, at least on Curse. Wild Turtle definitely should have been in full runaway mode. He was trying to save Lustboy's life, as most JD carries would.
Yeah.
Doesn't take the lantern, which delays Lustboy even further. And then they just run into a very scary Eve. TSM definitely should have gone back to base after getting that mid lane kill.
Great plays by Curse. The Perseverance pays off even more in following and chasing down the kills in bottom lane. Now 10-3. Things are looking grim for Team Solo Mid. 6,000 gold behind here, 18 minutes into the game. Look over at Quas' inventory. He's near maxed out on that. 120 on both sets of his Rod of Ages, going up to 200, so he's quite close. 212 in the mid lane from Bjergsen. He's still yet to die, and he's actually going for pure power. An elixir 19 minutes in. They got to make some plays with whatever chances they have.
Mm-hmm. They're running out of time for sure.
Yeah.
Double AP against Quas, who has already hit his Locket of the Iron Soul. Good luck killing him. Good luck killing Dominate either. Giant Spell, Negatron Cloak, Mercury Treads. Even a Hex Drinker thrown in there.
They've been already able to mitigate whatever TSM can think of in the next few buys, and that's what makes it very hard to come back. The big falter from here by Curse would be the only thing.
This has far-reaching implications as far as playoffs as well. Curse wins this, then save a CLG victory. They're going to be fourth. Hey, that Flaming Elephant is really good against top-tier teams.
They absolutely are on fire this game, too, according.
Think about it. I can't believe in their last 8 games against top 5 teams, they're actually 7-1. This will make them such a dangerous opponent to whoever has to play against them in the playoffs. Really, just this dark horse team now.
Oh my. You see the story of the game kind of playing out here for the top lane. Quas has just been able to do that the entire time. It's not spelling out too much CS for him, but the map control and the late game they're creating for themselves is more than they need in that area. See a little bit of play here from Dominate inside TSM's jungle. He's been here making sure there's been wards all the time. We still see that red ward, that pink ward, has not been cleared a second time, so the pressure they're creating is absolutely working. 30 seconds onto Dragon, and it looks like they are cleanly set up for this.
I don't even think TSM can contest this one. If they did, it would probably be suicide.
Very scary.
They can't get near Quas, especially if the team is near Quas. Curse's team, that is. Because this is too much initiation power, and it's too difficult for TSM to do damage to him right now.
They may not even need the full team. See Cop, yeah, he's able to actually spread away from the minions and get down there without being seen. So TSM, like you said, gonna let this one go. Be very close for a finished play to the Rune King as well on Cop coming up here. Wild Turtle only has a longsword to start that build for the same thing, probably. Good takeout. Third one of the game. Curse is on point right now. 38,000 to 30,000 gold.
Such a lead. You do not see leads like this not end in victory.
No.
Unless something really absurd happens.
So think about Curse's game yesterday. 19-minute Baron, 38-minute win. They just doubled their time and took the victory.
And Darius, he's got a lot of spells up that he's going to need to get out of this one.
He wants
with
the turret.
They lock him down, so he's going to definitely get the stun, followed by the binding. It's hard to move against these guys, Riv.
You know, nah. I was going to say, if he actually waited the crowd control, he could have teleported out, but there's no use.
Yeah.
It would just been for fun.
They have so much lockdown with those two.
Oh.
0-0, 0-5-0 for Darius. Not his game. Gets ganked once by Eve, gets ganked again by Eve.
Yeah, no more than a few
minutes later.
Then has
to deal with the Maokai.
Crazy pickups here from Curse. They allowed that Lulu to go through. Evelynn's first pick was really what they wanted, and it made an impact. Now, it wasn't Kog'Maw, it wasn't the Yasuo. Getting what they wanted all the way down the line, and they're working in these lanes perfectly. Somewhere that TSM should have won with that Lulu in lane, having Ori, Wild Turtle, and Lustboy. They should have been able to at least push back the Kog'Maw early game, but great play from Curse, 11-3 here, and really have been staying away from their falling into their old habits of trying to take too much when they do get a lead. They've been taking just the right amount every time.
They're looking really good. Even their win against LMQ yesterday was an impressive win.
The double AD again.
Played really smart.
So clean.
And again, their early game advantages. You get enough First Bloods, eventually you're going to learn how to turn them into victory. Dominate seems to get First Blood every single game now. Yeah, another binding lands. That'll be a lot of harass down on a turtle.
Right.
Orianna Shield helps that out quite a bit, actually. So he's still able to fight another day. But now they've got to deal with the split push of Void Boy. And there's no armor on Darius, so this is a really smart call by X Special and the rest of Curse to pull off this split push with Void Boy.
Interesting. Void Boy deciding Blade of the Rune King for himself this game. Seen quite a few Infinity Edges with the Yasuos coming in this week. That means he's going to be able to crush down turrets as well as when he gets to them.
We've seen TSM in this spot before. All right, they remembered. They got flanked. They're running away now. Void Boy's still trying to flank him, though.
The whole team saying deja vu. Going around. Oh, man.
Oh, no. No. Not again. At least Curse Gaming's on board.
Heck yeah. Oh, dear. Good take. A little back and forth there as Curse is trying to play cat and mouse with the buff.
Oh, no.
Oh, my word.
That is trouble.
A cursed Orianna ults today from any player. This is hurting units. 11-3, 25 minutes into the game. No minions necessary for the mid turret takedown. 24 minutes in, Curse starts to open up TSM's outer line. They're all down.
Really feels like TSM's tilting a little bit. They're just not making smart individual plays after making the strategic mistakes earlier on in the game. 9,000 gold is the deficit, but you can't admit Shaco's when you're up in gold. Missing when you're down in gold, you're just hopeless in this game.
It was the delivery system this time.
They would love to put, like, even with a great combo, unless they're catching a 5v3 or a 5v4, I still feel like TSM is losing these fights. They've just given up so much.
Then your damage is already down and it's being mitigated by Maelstrom, that Maokai ultimate, so that doesn't help. You're just trying to do all the damage.
Dominate might try and solo hold this one off. Some bad recall timings. Really timely push by TSM here to get that mid lane turret down. That gold will definitely benefit them. Plus, they can maybe sweep some pink wards or regular wards out on their way back to their own base.
Here comes
the trap. They're trying it.
Oh my gosh.
Nice burst.
That
here we go.
Perfect. Shockwave comes out. They already take down Xpecial. Soul Shackle will be locked down. Void Boy goes to the back line. Blade of the Rune King has not been used, so he can still chase. He can still stick. And that's what he's going to do. Pursuing over the wall. Qua still following. Misses his last Q. But can he follow up with anything else? Void Boy's summoners are down. Curse comes out on top of that fight. 2-for-1.
Even with the spectacular open there by TSM, that's really the only gambit that TSM had left. They're pushed back so low now. I wonder if Curse tries this. They could tank it with Quas pretty effectively, but it's a dangerous maneuver when they have this big of a lead. There's a chance they could fall behind. Oh, Bjergsen!
Oh, Cop gets it! Living Artillery hits. They got Vision on Bjergsen.
One more.
He gets one more. It's not going to even matter. The red buff takes him down first. He also gets a little bit of a refresh, I believe, on that blue. Yes, he does. So he can start
blue
firing out even more.
onto Kog'Maw. That blue buff is huge as far as poke around this Baron Pit. The rest of TSM has respawned, but Curse is going to use that poke and vision advantage and their gold lead to try and just get something good going.
What a great game all around here. They have waves that are placed just to either side of them nicely. Just quickly having Void Boy and Cop farm them. Great job by Curse. Playing off the ball here and making sure everything is in their favor before they make too many big moves. See this one more time. Especial was not a part of this fight, so that was a 4v5.
Yeah, he got completely burst down. But I mean, look at Kwas in the middle of things. Everyone on TSM has to scatter.
That mitigate.
They used all their damage on the support, which meant there was none left for Void Boy. There's just no chance there when he's rolling like that on Yasuo. They better get this one fast, because Curse is coming.
Oh dear. You know, Jed, I said a few times, we always see teams on the analyst desk and they say, we were that far ahead. I think Curse knows that they're that far ahead this time. A huge lead for them. 11,000 gold now coming in under 30 minutes. Especial, he says, you took me down last time. I'm going to initiate this fight this time. Oh, wow.
Sneaky
great
moves.
Flash over the wall from Amazing. But that's everything in retreat, Jet. TSM's not on the forward motion here. They're going for defense.
They do take down Dyrus yet again. And they burn more defensive summoner spells from TSM after already taking that dragon. They're putting TSM into harder and harder decisions here as they continue to clear vision away from the Baron Pit. No scrying orb is available right now. Dyrus actually just purchased one, I think.
Yeah.
Because they know they're going to need that vision around Baron. It's going down fast.
And it's getting tougher for TSM that they're falling behind. That all-in team can't go all-in.
The one chance would be a smite steal with an Orianna ult right on top of it. Amazing would be in position for that.
Bjergsen's not. Coming up closer.
Oh, nice shot.
Bye-bye, Lost Boy. Looking for a little too much towards the Baron Pit. Kwas gets what he can. Cop fires a long-range one to hit up Amazing as he makes his way out of the fight. And Curse is really able to just pull TSM along on a string right now.
Kill after kill, ward kill after ward kill. They are starving TSM out right now. It's a strategy that TSM has made a lot of bank doing themselves. But it's being done to them right now. You can definitely see Curse with four sweeping lenses and the scrying orb, relying on special purchasing wards to get as much done here. There's a slight risk, actually, when you run so many scrying orbs that you yourself lose your own vision and can get caught by the enemy team. But Curse is confident enough in their gold lead that they don't think that could happen.
They're doing all right.
That's the vision denial. That's what TSM sees. But then you can see what Curse sees as well. Isn't all that great. They're just using their gold lead to go where they want.
Thank you very much, says Dominate.
He's having a great game.
He is. His Eve play has been spectacular lately. The scores may not be amazing, but it's that last guy that's doing the impact plays with 10% of his HP left, staying alive to get out the last hits and really making the fight count for the team. You don't have to have a good scoreline to have a good game. 30 minutes in, Dominate, though, very good scoreline this game. It's been paying off for every lane. Another Baron here to push TSM.
Amazing's flag is down. He can't get in. He used the flag to scout. Now he can't make it into the Baron, but that's Baron for Curse.
30 minutes. They take Baron down for themselves. 8 more minutes and how they ended the game on LMQ. Can they do it now versus Team Solo Mid?
13,000 gold lead and the Baron.
So big
itemization jumps. The Infinity Edge completed onto Void Boy.
Yeah, I did that after the last fight.
It's going to be tough to hold this turret, that's for sure. Kwas might just as well go in. His flash is almost up on Maokai. When that is up, I kind of expect them to just go all in and try and end the game. Especially with Thyra split pushing here, they can get the jump on him and make a very quick work of the TSM team.
Thyra's throwing as much glitter around as he can in the bottom lane. See if he can get that turret down. That's the only pressure they have left.
It's all about whether Curse is willing to pull the trigger right now. The fact that they've sent no one back for Dyrus is a pretty good indicator that they're diving on the next wave.
All right. Dominates on the front line. The Banshee's Veil to be popped. It does. Here's Dyrus' teleport. They're diving. Oh my gosh! The health bars completely obliterated on the side of TSM. Wild Turtle and Bjergsen are down. The DPS in the lanes is out. They only have utility from Amazing and Lust Boy now, and that's not even going to be enough. Eyes focused on the turret. The inhibitor starts to go down. Curse making a move for the Nexus.
Kwas and Void Boy caught both TSM carries in that knockup. The perfect engage, and TSM had no counter.
What a beautifully run game here from Curse from start to finish. Hashtag elephant on fire throughout the whole game, running down the tracks. 19-5, coming up on 32. Curse will happily take a game off of Team Solo Mid, a 1-3 overall in the split. Curse takes down Team Solo Mid.
This is a scary team now, and everyone in the LCS is going to take notice as Curse moves towards the playoffs now. They dismantled teams this Super Week. Aside from that misstep they had against Complexity of all teams at the start, they crushed people. They have different champion selects, great champion pools across the board, and everyone is stepping up at the right moment here.
What a great play. Dominate has been coming up very big for the team. He's a huge voice within the shot calling, and even if he's not the voice, that's the guy they're following on these initiations.
And X Special coming across from TSM, he pretty much was always the support at the top of the table for assists. You think jumping to a team that was sitting in sixth place the entire year, that would harm him. No, he's still second in assists in the North American LCS. And Curse ends the split on a fantastic win streak.
A great pick and ban phase from Curse, I think, set them up
in
a beautiful
was.
Spot, pushing that Jarvan onto amazing. And they first picked Evelynn to make sure it happened.
And then the Lulu was taken by Dyrus.
Right. And like, oh man, they gave that up.
Actually, they were planning on destroying him in lane with Maokai and Eve. 0-7-0 for that Lulu by the end of the game for Dyrus.
Elephant's on fire.
Yeah, I guess so. It was really impressive. That has the analyst desk will go over exactly what that means for the playoffs.
Yep.
But I'm pretty sure, I'm 100% sure, Curse is no longer the sixth seed. Right? That will either fall to Dignitas. No, it'll fall to Dignitas.
Right.
Just thought about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we were talking about the first
TSM
game,
in the first round of the playoffs.
Going to be a tough game, and we said why TSM wanted that game as much as they could. To go 4-0 against the team you're going to face again, why not? That's not going to be the chance this time, though. TSM is what against Dignitas? 1-3.
Yep.
That's a little bit more rough than going against the 4-0.
It's a little different than someone they could have been 4-0 against. But honestly, who wants to play Curse right now? If they're not playing EG or Complexity, they're pretty much winning all their games. That's now 8-1 in their last 9 games against the teams that are in the playoffs. Right? They're best of 5s in the playoffs, and it's pretty scary.
Well,
right now, maybe Curse's play style works better in best of ones. Honestly, because they're doing a lot of those Tristana mid things. They pull out a Talon. Those are little things you get one game by. And when you enter into a best of 5, the complexion kind of changes.
Well, let's see what some of those best of 5s could be, actually. We have a bracket we could pull up on the screen. Go over this just a little bit more on how it could actually play out.
Yeah, exactly. So Team Solo Mid and Dignitas is locked in. That means the 4th and 5th seed is going to be CLG
right.
And Curse. It's just we don't know exactly who's going to be playing who. The winner of that goes through to play LMQ or Cloud9, depending on what happens in these next two games.
Absolutely. And I believe we're getting Voidboy set up for an interview on the desk so we can figure out really what was going through Curse's head there.